Hello and welcome back. The solemnity of the ascension of Jesus into heaven seems to us like a goodbye. Jesus is leaving the world to go up to his throne at the right hand of the Father, leaving his disciples behind. But the scene of the ascension is not what it seems. Although Jesus is leaving the world, he promises that he will not leave his friends as orphans. He has promised them the Paraclete, the Holy Spirit. We read in the Gospel of St. Luke that Jesus says to his apostles, "You are my witnesses, and I will send to you what my Father promised, but remain here in Jerusalem until you receive power from heaven." I'd like to consider for a few moments that word "until," because it signifies a period of time, whether long or short. The apostles did not know how much time they would be in Jerusalem, waiting for the fulfillment of Jesus' promise, the Holy Spirit. This period of time between the ascension and Pentecost, between Jesus leaving and the coming of the Spirit, is signified by the word "until." It really was no more than 10 days that the disciples waited for the Spirit to come, but for us the "until" can seem endless. What am I saying? Between a problem and its resolution, there can be many days, weeks, months, or years. From sickness to healing. From the arrival of the coronavirus to the discovery of a vaccine. From the loss of a job until a new job appears. From sadness to joy. From separation to reunion. From leaving to return. From the sending of a letter to a reply. From a promise to its fulfillment. Now, at times, the "until" can seem like an "if." If I'm cured. If they develop a vaccine. If I find work. If the soldier returns to his family. If I see my friend again. And the "if" implies doubt. After a week in Jerusalem, did the apostles say, "if the Spirit comes," or did they have doubts about Jesus' promise that the Spirit would come upon them? And such is our experience. Despite our prayers and supplications, our patience departs us, and sometimes desperation enters in. It seems to us that the Lord doesn't hear us or has forgotten us. But Jesus is always faithful to his promises and gives us this promise until it's fulfilled. In the letter of James we read, "Beloved, have patience until the Lord comes." The farmer who hopes to gather the precious yield has to wait with patience the yearly, the early, and the late rains. You must also have patience and remain strong. So when the farmer plants seeds in the earth, he has to wait until the seeds grow and they ripen into a harvest. The seed is the promise, and the harvest is the fulfillment of the promise. Between the promise and its fulfillment is the waiting, like the farmer who has to wait with patience the early and the late rains. The conception of a baby is a promise, and its birth is a fulfillment. The 9 months of the preparation, the waiting, the meanwhile, the until. Neither the farmer nor the mother, nor we, have control over the coming of the rains or the child or the Spirit. We wait. Waiting is difficult, but the Lord has given us the gift of hope, and with this gift, we are able to be patient. Notice that the time between the conception and the birth, between planting and harvest, requires patience, prayer, and work. Weeding, hoeing, doctor visits, preparing a nursery. After the ascension of Jesus, the apostles waited in Jerusalem. And what was their work? St. Luke tells us that they returned to Jerusalem and were in the temple praising God. Let's reverse roles for just a moment. Could God be waiting for us? Does Jesus have an "until" with us, waiting for us to act in his name, to be his witnesses? I imagine that Jesus waits the growth of the gifts of the Spirit in us, wisdom, understanding, counsel, fortitude, knowledge, piety, and fear of the Lord. These gifts were planted in us at baptism and confirmation. But do we use these gifts? Do we depend upon them? Do they grow in us? At times, we experience challenges in the form of losses of health, of jobs, of friends, even of love. During these times, we have to plant the seed of hope, water and care for it with prayer and praise to the Lord. And meanwhile, the Lord waters us with his grace. Like the sun, he shines his love on us, and he tills the soil of our life and makes it fertile, in order to be witnesses of the good news of God's mercy and the promise of eternal life. God did this with the apostles and does the same with us in spite of our fears and disappointments. The period of until can seem very long, but the Lord is faithful to his promises and to his people. What is more, we have received the Holy Spirit in baptism and confirmation. With his gifts, we can do more than we can passively wait for the passing of our problems. We can praise God here in his holy temple, or in the Blessed Sacrament Chapel, in our homes, and serve in the world with our actions of love and service for those in need. The more we serve our brothers and sisters, the shorter seems the time between the promise and the fulfillment. The shorter seems the until of the fulfillment of God's promises. And at the same time, we will keep our promises to serve and love God in the persons of our neighbors. They need not wait for our love.